In this tutorial, we are going to work with the Parallax effect in After Effects. The Parallax effect is very easy to create if we learn the basic principles. As a setup, we will have a vehicle moving down the street. The objects around it moving backwards will make it look like the vehicle is moving forward. The most important thing to consider when creating this animation is the proximity of the objects to the camera, and that objects closer to the camera should move faster than objects farther away from the camera. Just by paying attention to this, we can create a smooth animation. When we repeat these movements by taking them in a loop, it will look like the vehicle in the scene is moving forward. As we always do, let's first look at what's happening in our scene. The points that won't move, our pet won't move here, and the buildings and hills in the background won't move. I will keep the background separate from the rest of what we are going to do, because we will not move anything on the background. I can also lock it for that. To avoid any intervention on the background, let's get to know the layers first. The back layer is the objects in the background that are ahead of the sidewalk. We have a light. Closer to the light, we have the stripes on the road. On this side of the sidewalk, we have another light closer to the camera, closer to us, and some grass. Now, we are going to animate this. To start the movement, I press the letter P on the keyboard, P for position. When I press the letter P on the layer, it will automatically open this position and we can animate it. I click on the icon on the left side of the position. Either drag this x-axis forward to the right or select the layer here. By selecting the layer in this way, we make the object come out of the frame, and when we come a little bit further, we make this object come out of the frame to the left like this. So, the effect is like this. You understand the basic logic. In this way, we will edit the position on other layers. Let's do them right away. I'm clicking on the icon on the left side of position. I'm losing this light from here, from the frame. So, here is what we are going to do. Since this light object is closer to us, it will disappear from the frame a little bit faster. So, we are going to set it to the left side, not on top of the previous keyframe, so that it will be faster. So it will be like this. Now let's apply this animation on the road lanes that are a bit closer to us. I'm pressing the letter P. I'm clicking on the icon of position. And we need to do something like this on these lanes. Normally, when we repeat these lanes in this way, one part will be empty. However, what we call a strip is a situation that will be repeated continuously. We will do the strips like this. We have given the position keyframe. Now, I press the letter S. I press the S of scale. I click once on the lock icon to the left of the numbers, so that we enlarge only on the X axis or only on the Y axis by opening the lock icon. So here is how I'm trying to do the magnification. Now let's go back to the position. I'm zooming in like this and bringing it behind the light. And now, I'm moving the timeline a little bit further and bringing it behind the light again like this. So, we have got this. We are going to make these animations continuous by repeating them later on. Now, I will continue. I'm making the light in front. Normally, these lights should be similar. But of course, you can do it however it looks good to your eyes. And of course, in the timeline position, I'm going to remove it from here. I will go a little bit further and I will move the light a little bit to the left. I'm taking it out of the frame. Let's do the same thing with the grass in front. I'm pressing the letter P. I press the icon here. I take the grass out of the frame and I will adjust it so that it's a little bit more in front, to the left. After doing this logic, you can look at this animation, the resulting animation, and you can lengthen or shorten the edits to make them more realistic. It was such an animation. It would be more effective if there was a boat in the distance, or if there was another graphic in the distance, if it was further away. These are very close to each other, but it's still appropriate to show how the animation is. Now let's come to expression. If you have followed our previous tutorials, we have used loopout as an expression in a few tutorials, and we will use loopout here. Loopout means repeat the animation here. By pressing Alt key on the keyboard, I click on the icon that we have keyframed and this field opens. We can write text in this field. We will write loopout in this way and we will open and close parentheses. We will have defined the loopout function. When I click anywhere, you will be able to see that it is now moving regularly. I am playing it. Notice the grass. The grass really looks like the camera is moving. We will give the loopout expression for the others. We won't bother writing it one by one for this. I hover over the position, right click, copy expression only, so only the expression will be copied. Let's select the other four floating layers. You remember, we didn't select the one at the back. We even locked it, so we wouldn't touch it. We will select the other four layers that we gave position animation and press Ctrl V. So, we are going to paste. I press Ctrl V on the keyboard, so you can see that they are all red. It means that there is a keyframe in the position expression. Now, let's look at our scene again. I am playing it. Anything in the center can look like it's moving forward. Let's add a cylinder like this in the center and let's adjust it so that it's over the strip and behind the light here. And let's move it. Suppose the object here is a car. It looks like it's moving. I even quickly found an image of a car on the internet and we will see what it looks like when we place this image like this. I'm playing it again and we want the car to go in its own lane. I can move it a little bit further. In this way, we complete our animation. You can also use this technique to create moving objects, objects that look like they are moving. That's it for this tutorial. If today's video was useful to you, don't forget to subscribe to my YouTube channel right now. Just click on the subscribe button below this video. Thank you for watching.